साक्षात् परं ब्रह्म तस्मै श्री गुरवे नमः तस्मै श्री गुरवे नमः तस्मै श्री गुरवे नमः
वी आर इन पंचदशी चैप्टर 13 वर्स नंबर 94 एंड so in the previous verse it was told how are the names and forms to be dropped and there it was told upeksha nama rupe dve upeksha be indifferent to the names and forms that is the only way you can drop the names and forms how does one understand that the paramatma tattva is none other than himself so see there are two things one must be indifferent to the names and forms and the second is one must be attentive to the self both things so whenever we are in the world we must be remain indifferent to the names and forms and when a certain level of indifference has been cultivated then when that mind is naturally remaining indifferent then what to do become तदा द्रष्टुः स्वरूपे अवस्थानम् नाउ स्टार्ट बी अटेंटिव ऑफ द आई इफ यू आर नॉट अटेंटिव ऑफ द वर्ल्ड यू आर इनडिफरेंट टू द वर्ल्ड द अटेंशन हैज टू गो समवेयर लेट दैट अटेंशन गो टू द सेल्फ
जलस्थेधो मुखे स्वस्य जलस्थेधो मुखे स्वस्य देहे दृष्टेऽप्युपेक्षतम् देहे दृष्टेऽप्युपेक्षतम् तीरस्थ एव देहे स्वे तीरस्थ एव देहे स्वे तात्पर्यं स्याद्यथा तथा तात्पर्यं स्याद्यथा तथा
A very beautiful example is given how you can be indifferent and at the same time be attentive of the self. Very, very beautiful. We do it every day. Well, we don't stand in front of the waters every day, but we stand in front of the mirror. So here it is told, just as a person standing on the banks of a lake sees his reflection upside down, he disregards that vertical inversion and comes to identify with his own normal body, so also an aspirant after realization disregarding names and forms should know himself as pure Brahman.
See, when we are looking in the mirror or we are looking into the waters of the lake, you are getting opposite. The right ear seems to be left ear in the reflection. The right eye becomes the left eye in the reflection. But you don't get confused by that inversion. When you want to look at, you are looking at the reflection, but your attention is on the original body, which is on the shore. So if you want to, because you are seeing the left eye as the right eye as the left eye, you don't go and अरे यार पता नहीं विच आई शुड आई फिक्स इज इट दिस आई और दिस आई ऑटोमेटिकली योर हैंड गोज टू द राइट आई दैट नीड्स टू और द हेयर और द हैंड देर इज नो कन्फ्यूजन यू आर मूविंग द राइट हैंड व्हेन यू सी द रिफ्लेक्शन यू डोंट फील आई एम मूविंग द लेफ्ट हैंड आई वाई आई थिंक दिस इज वेरी कन्फ्यूजिंग आई एम मूविंग राइट हैंड एंड इन द रिफ्लेक्शन देर इज लेफ्ट हैंड दिस टाइप ऑफ डाउट डज नॉट कम टू यू इजंट इट Why it doesn't come to you? Because you are seeing the reflection, but you are not taking it to be real. You are taking yourself to be the real, in spite of the reflection. This is exactly what has to be done in the world. When we move around in the world, all the names and forms, the whole world is the reflection. Of what? Of mine. Don't be too serious about it, just like you are not too serious about the reflection. Be attentive on the self, the real you.
So here the teacher says, when one looks at the at one's own reflection in the water upside down, one ignores the appearance of being upside down. Because one's real attention is on himself. Who is on the shore? Who is on the shore? He knows that the reflection is not the reality, that he is the one who is reflected. Once he understands the truth, he does not get disturbed by the inverse state of his reflection. All the phenomena that seems to disturb and distort the reflection neither hurts the reflection, which is a non-existent entity, nor the object. So also the modifications, the joys and the sorrows neither belong to Paramatma nor to the Jivatma. They have no status. What does not have any status? See, now think, you are standing in front of the waters, and you are, when you look into the waters, you will look at upside down photograph, reflection is there. The waves are coming, the reflection is getting distorted, sometimes it's getting broken up. Sometimes the sun's rays come and you're not able to see the reflection because it's shining exactly on the spot where the reflection was supposed to be. Sometimes the muddy waters are there and you're not able to see the reflection. Does that disturb you? It doesn't disturb us, the original me, the person. Exactly the same way. So where are these disturbances? Is the reflection getting disturbed? Is the reflection getting disturbed? No. Because reflection is only an appearance. How can appearance get disturbed by the muddy waters or by the waves or by the sun or by the heat and cold? It will not get affected. Are you getting affected? The original? No. By all the changes that are taking place in the reflection, are you getting affected? No. Exactly the same way, the reflection is the Jivatma, and the reflected is the Paramatma. Neither Jivatma gets affected by what? By the changes in the body, breath, mind and intellect. Jivatma does not get affected. Does the Paramatma get affected? He is all knowing. He does not get affected either. Then where is this? Why do we feel that we are affected? Because of our identification. That is the only reason. The joys and the sorrows neither belong to Paramatma nor to the Jivatma. They have no status. Where are they then? What is their position? Where are they located, these joys and sorrows? They are existing in their own absence. This is the effect of Maya. They are existing in their own absence, just as the blueness of the sky exists in its own absence. To be serious, to be so attached to this phenomena. What is the phenomena now? Tell me. You have heard this chapter for so long. What is the phenomena?
Breathing.
Breathing is phenomena. What else? The senses are the phenomena. What else? Mind is the phenomena. At the totality level, the Prakriti is the phenomena. The Maya is the phenomena. At the individual level, the mind is the phenomena. And in this mind, the intellectual sheath, the mental sheath, the vital air sheath, the gross body sheath, all this is a concept of the mind. Don't think that mind is inside something. No. In the mind, the thought of the body is there. How can you know the body if the thought of body is not there? How can you know the mind if the thought of mind in the mind is not there? But where is the mind? Existing in its own absence. It's just a make-believe thing. So don't get, and we are, when Paramatma as if gets attached to this phenomena, he is called as Jivatma. is called as Jivatma. Is this attachment possible? Paramatma getting attached to the phenomena called mind, is it possible? No. It is not possible. Because Paramatma is all-knowing. Paramatma is self-existing. But then our experience is that we are attached, isn't it? So, till we do not recognize that we are of the nature of Paramatma, till then this practice, this inquiry, this contemplation, this meditation has to go on. Because we are not accepted, the vision has not changed. We are not seeing phenomena as a phenomena. We are seeing this body, breath, mind, intellect with the life expressing through it as a real entity. That is the problem. What we have to take? We have to take the Brahman, the pure consciousness, as the reality. Everything else as the phenomena. And then have the courage to interact with that phenomena in the correct way. What is the correct way? Be indifferent to it. Be indifferent to the phenomena. Now the teacher moves to the theme of how plurality is an illusion and Advaita Tattva is the real bliss of being. Sahasrasho mano rajye, sahasrasho mano rajye, vartamane sadaivatata, vartamane sadaivatata. Sarvai rupekshate yadvada, sarvai rupekshate yadvada, upeksha nama rupayoho, upeksha nama rupayoho. Just as thousands of mental projections, although present, are always disregarded by people, so also one should disregard the names and forms and come to realize Brahman. Just like throughout the day, we are imagining so many things in our mind. So many thoughts come. How many do we actually hold on to? Only few. Millions and millions of thoughts just come and go away, come and go away, come and go away. And out of that, few of them you get identified and all hell begins. Isn't it? So that's what the teacher is saying here, that although one builds many castles in the air, has many fantasies in real life, one ignores them all as of no validity. Similarly, so you ask a youth, he wants to buy a sports car, he wants to get this job, he wants to get become a millionaire before he's 30, this, that, blah, 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 so many things. And as he's growing up, he may have had all those fantasies, but he comes back to reality eventually as the time passes. When they are talking among themselves, when we are thinking on our own, I will do this, I'll do that, I'll go there, I'll come here, I'll enjoy in this way, I'll live my life in this manner. But where have all those ideas, where have all those projections gone? They have become null and void because they came and they went. Your attention was on what was on hand, isn't it? Some people are not like that. Some people keep living in their fantasies. Similarly, many names and forms, many experiences come and go, but one should totally disregard them all. So, whether hunger, thirst, disease and health, so many experiences, heat and cold experiences coming, every day it is different. Do we remember what was the weather yesterday? Do we remember what we ate yesterday? Do we remember our hunger yesterday? Or even this morning, or even this afternoon, or even 1 hour ago, what was your state of mind? Nothing remains with us. Everything that comes, everything that we have experienced in our life, every moment that is taking place, but very quickly we forget. That is the nature of the mind, to let go, let go. It is just a flushing system, emptying itself. But because of our, anyway, come up till here, that just like, so with regards to your mind also, remain indifferent. Don't become identified to certain thoughts, certain roles, certain situations, certain experiences. Don't make, blow them out of proportion. Like someone got sick here. Oh, you got sick! You know, that tone automatically shows that over concern. Remain cool, remain calm. It's okay. It happens. Everyone is getting a sore throat. Everyone, every now and then, everyone goes and falls down somewhere. By mistake, nobody is doing it purposely. For that to become so panicked and over concerned. Oh, is the leg okay? Is that okay? Is that okay? It's not required. Take a chill pill. Interact everything. Interact with everything with indifference. As if we are going to be able to do anything. Are we going to, by our panicking, by over interaction in that situation, are we going to be able to solve it? Solve the other person's pain? No. See? What is the status of this manorajya, the mental projections? Kshane kshane manorajyam. Kshane kshane manorajyam. Bhavatyevanyathanyatha. Bhavatyenvanyathanyatha. Gatam gatam punar nasti, gatam gatam punar nasti, vyavaharo bahistatha, vyavaharo bahistatha. A multitude of mental projections are imagined and they do occur from moment to moment. However, they disappear for good. Our dealings in the outer world should be treated in a similar way. So here the teacher is telling, just like you deal with your mind, if you were to become serious with every projection that comes in our mind, if you become serious about every projection that comes in your mind, you'll go crazy. Just going out of the house here on Wolseley Avenue, when I reach the end, should I turn left? First projection. Should I turn right? Second projection. If I give equal importance to both, I'll go mad. I'll be going in a circle there only. See? And usually you just make one decision and you never think about the other projection that had come about, the other thought that had come about. Imagination that I should go this way or I should go that way. Will traffic be more on Gallagher's Road or will the traffic be more on Springvale Road? Should I eat this or should I eat that? You don't, at that moment it seems important, but afterwards there is zero value to it. Thoughts, imaginings, values, priorities keep changing from moment to moment. Even one's mind cannot be taken for granted. So is the case with all the objects and experiences in the world. So just like we are not so serious about all the thought projections in our mind, similarly, do not be very serious about all the objects of the, all the names and forms of the world. Don't give them too much importance. What is our life at this moment? Our life, a common man's life, is continuously yo-yoing between the past memories and the future expectations. You know, one year ago I had a business and today I don't have a business. 5 years ago I was a millionaire, today I am not a millionaire. You know, 20 years ago my child did this.
You know, when my when I was small, I was all memories. Can you ever relive them? They're projections now. Can you do anything about what has happened from last 50, 60 years? Nothing can be done about it. So why waste energy remembering them? They're dead and gone. Cannot bring about any lasting change in what has already happened. And yet, we spend so much time remembering our past. For what? Instead, live in the present. But this insistence, this is insistence. Out of all the memories from childhood till this moment, of the past, you are only selecting few memories to interact with, not every damn thing that has gone by, isn't it? You have given more than required attention to them, value to them. So don't do that. And similarly, the second part of the mind, rest of the mind, it is continuously expecting, I will do this, I will do that, I will go and travel, I will become this, I will do meditation there, I will build another house, I will this, I have to have lunch or dinner afterwards, I have to go to sleep afterwards, I have to write these emails afterwards, I have to answer the letters afterwards, I have to call this person afterwards. Continuously thinking, what has to be done. And when it becomes out of control, then anxiety comes. And if we forget what we have to do, then the medical term is you are getting dementia, you are becoming forgetful. It is not being forgetful. Why you want to have that type of language about yourself? You are just not interested. Let the world speak what they want to speak. Dementia, okay, dementia, I prefer that way, to be that way. I don't want to remember the past. I don't want to remember the future, worry about the future. I want to live in the present. What is there right now? You three are there. What are your names? Cut. Okay, thank you. Tomorrow, what is your name? No problem. We are shortchanging ourselves by losing ourselves in the past and the future. And that is only because, and what are past in the future? Nothing but projections. Nothing but imaginations of your mind. Memories are nothing but imaginations. Impressions. Even on a soft skin, if I press like this, there will be an impression of the fingers. But after some time, it becomes okay, isn't it? So is true with the mind also. The impressions form because of the circumstances, because of how much value and attention you are given. But after some time, they go away. But if you keep repeating it, if I put down there, I keep putting it, then it will not go away, it will travel. Whatever goes, never comes back. So here the teacher is prompting us to give no value to the world of names and forms. All the experiences, and what is our experience? Waking world, dream world, and deep sleep world. We don't think too much about the deep sleep world because we get the bliss there. We don't think too much about the dream world because it is imaginary, it comes and goes. But we become too serious about the waking world. What value you give to the dream world, the same value needs to be given to the waking world also. All the names and forms in the dream world were given zero value the moment you woke up. Similarly, in the waking state, we have to give zero value
And what is that zero value? Be indifferent. Be indifferent to all the names and forms. What is that which never returns?
Na balyam yauvane labhyam. Na balyam yauvane labhyam. Yauvanam sthavire tatha. Yauvanam sthavire tatha. Mruta pita punar nasti. Mruta pita punar nasti. Nayatyeva gatam dinam. Nayatyeva gatam dinam.
Childhood is lost in youth. The youth disappears in old age. A diseased father never comes back. So also a day that has passed never returns. If the dream world and the dream experiences are an illusion, so are the experiences in the waking world. What was yesterday is not today. Every moment is a changing moment. There is nothing real in this world except this about this truth about the world, that it is continuously changing every moment. You may not be aware of it, but that is only our foolishness, our insistence that it is not changing. You can't sit still also for one moment, isn't it? Continuously the hand going here, hand going there, mouth opening, eyes blinking, heart beating. Can't sit still. Life is nothing but change. Don't give it too much importance. If you are looking for solace, if you are looking for tranquility, peace, happiness, God realization, self realization, then you have to get intoxicated with the source. If you are intoxicated by the world, it will keep you throwing left, right, left, center, everywhere, up and down. Because of our identification with the world, whatever is the nature of world, we start going through the we think that we are going through the world because we consider ourselves to be a part of the world. But the truth is, world is our part, not we are part of the world. Wave is thinking the water, that I'm a part of the water. The wave is thinking I'm a part of the ocean. It doesn't realize that ocean is its part, because essentially the wave is water. Without water, ocean is also not possible. Similarly, we are thinking this whole world, we are a part of the world. No, we are that Brahman, we are that truth, we are that divinity in whom this whole world is existing. Not outside of it, inside of it. Just like the whole dream world was existing within me, similarly the whole waking world is also existing within me. This contemplation is required. Not Wednesday to Wednesday. Take this thought and keep thinking. Can't come to a conclusion. But attempt has to be made. How is the world in me? Keep thinking the way scriptures are asking you to think. Panchadashi is asking you to think. Perception is not the authority for reality.
Manorajad visheshakah. Manorajad visheshakah. Kshanadhvamsini laukike. Kshanadhvamsini laukike. Atosmin bhasamane pi. Atosmin bhasamane pi. Tat satyatva dhiyam tyajet. Tat satyatva dhiyam tyajet. Tat satyatva dhiyam tyajet. What is a speciality that can be associated with the constantly perishing objects of the world in comparison to the mental imaginations? Therefore, although they appear,
the notion of reality in them should be rejected. Although the phenomena appears, sunset and sunrise appears, but the reality of the sunrise and sunset, that you have already given up in your mind. Because you know in your mind, sun does not come down, sun does not rise. It's a phenomena. Similarly, the waxing and waning of the moon is a phenomena. You know it is the reflection of the sun, the earth coming in between the sun and the moon, which is causing this phenomena. The sun, moon does not become dark or become full. It is always as it is, isn't it? See? The eclipse of the sun, same thing. It's a phenomena. It is not a reality. You don't go into a panic, what will happen to us now if the sun is vanishing? Sun is not vanishing. The phenomena of Viraj waters is there, you see it, but you don't give it a status of reality, therefore you don't drink that water, isn't it? You know it is just the conditions, prevalent conditions are creating that phenomena. Similarly, prevalent conditions have created the phenomena called the world. The prevalent conditions created the phenomena called dream. Similarly, deep sleep. And now, the waking. It is only the conditions that are creating this. Don't give it a status of reality. What is the status of reality? That the worst case scenario, the Gaunatma is the status of reality, that I am a husband, I am a wife, I am a brother, and I have to do my duties, this, that, it's all. You are imagining in your head that you are a brother, and at that level, there you cannot think of anything but the duty, 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 duty. Your dharma means duty alone. The day, because of your contemplations, you have come to Mithyatma, that I am the one who is you are disidentified with the world to a large extent, but you are still recognizing that you are identified with the body, breath, mind, intellect, equipment. Then what happens at this stage? Then your identification with this Mithyatma and disidentification with the Gaunatma makes you do the sadhana. That I have to give up this Mithyatma also. Then yoga, pranayama, japa, contemplation, meditation, all this begins at the Mithyatma level. See? And if you don't do that, again you will fall back into Gaunatma. And as you purify the Mithyatma, do this, then somewhere along the way, you realize that you are the Mukhyatma. So right now you know Gaunatma, Mithyatma, Mukhyatma. Where are you right now? If you think you are a student, you are Gaunatma. If you think you are a student, you are Gaunatma. If I think I am a teacher, Gaunatma. So we are at the lowest rung of the ladder. If while listening to these words and talking to these words, our attention is going on, oh, I must do this, I must change this, I must contemplate like this. So where are we in our mind? So we are Mithyatma. But if listening to this satsang, because life has brought me at this moment in this place, at place and time, and while listening to it, our attention is going to not the Gaunatma, not the body, breath, mind, intellect, but on the essence that I am, then we are where we are supposed to be. Nothing requires to be done. Keep the attention there all the time. Not on the questions erupting in the mind, not on the seeking of answers, not on the doubts. Because where are the doubts? Where are the doubts? In the mind. Where are the questions? In the mind. Where are the answers? In the mind. Are required for the mind. Does the self need any question and answers? Do you need to prove that you exist? Do you need to prove that you are alive? No. There's no question about it. There's no question about that we exist. That I exist at this moment. There is no question about it. That I am present. There is no question about it. Be aware of that. But the moment we get into the mind, question answers, doubts. Therefore, what is the difference between the constantly changing fantasies created by the imagination and the constantly changing nature of the world? Both are destroyed every moment, both are transient. So the world is also continuously changing. The imaginations in our mind are also continuously changing, meaning thoughts are also continuously changing. The world is also not permanent, the thoughts in our mind also are not permanent. This is the similarity between the two. So if you are not giving value to all the thoughts that are coming in your mind, so also don't give value to all the things and beings that come to you in the world. Be indifferent to them, just like you are indifferent to the thoughts in the mind. The instrument through which the mental projections, Manorajya, and the perception of the world is achieved itself is not the reality. So here the teacher is saying, where is the what is the faculty where the Manorajya is taking place? Mind. He says, mind itself is not a reality. Why? Mind is a phenomena, isn't it? Just like wave is a phenomena, mind is a phenomena. Mind is not real. Mind is existing in its own absence. Then what is real? The one who knows that this mind is coming and going, sometimes thinking, sometimes feeling, sometimes waking, sometimes dreaming, sometimes sleeping. The one who knows this, he is the real one. But what do? We shortchange ourselves and become the waker, become the dreamer, become the deep sleeper. When we become the waker, we don't stop there. We become the body. We become the breath, breathing mechanism. We become the mind. We become the intellect. Even if you come to the stage of waker, fantastic. Nothing in this world will disturb you. But we don't stop there. We, as a waker, consciousness expressing as the waker gets identified with the, chooses to identify with body, breath, mind, intellect. We don't stop there. Then we become the brother, father, sister, husband, etc., etc. So come back always. Remain attentive about the real you, not the imaginary you. Imaginary you is the Gaunatma and the Mithyatma. Real you is the Mukhyatma. The instrument through which the mental projections, Manorajya, and the perception of the world is achieved itself is not the reality. The instrument through which all this is experienced is the mind. Mind itself is not the reality. So perception is not necessarily the test of reality. With the children I used to do this exercise. Is seeing believing or believing is seeing? Which is true? What you see is with your eyes, is that the truth, or what you believe in, that is the truth? See? Because seeing is very limited. Seeing is very limited. We are not living, if those people who are living at the perceptory level, they are at the mercy of the perceptions. Now you decide, are you living only at the perceptory level, or are you living at a deeper faith level? And that faith in God, faith in that divine, faith in yourself is guiding you to sift through all the perceptions, isn't it? Or even though the perceptions are coming, you are interacting with them based on the faith that you have. See? Otherwise, if you gave reality to every perception, you will go crazy.
Seeing and believing is science, and believing and seeing is
spirituality. Yes. Absolutely. Therefore, the idea that because one sees the world, it is real, must be dropped, because perception does not give validity to the world. Senses do not give validity to the world. So whatever we see is not real. Because we see a ghost in the night, it is not real. Because we see mirage waters, the waters are not real. Because we see sunrise and sunset, it has not become real. We are seeing it, but there is no reality in it, isn't it? It's a phenomena. We see the waves, but it is not real. Water is real. We see the ornaments. Ornaments are not real. Gold is real. We see the pots. Pots are not real, the mud is real. See? A shift in vision or perception has to come about. So what is the pot here? What is a wave? What is a pot? What is an ornament? Name and form. So name and form is not the reality. Name and form is not the reality. Find out what the reality is. What is that which has gone into making that name and form? It was the mud which went into make the pot. It was the gold which was existing before also, during the ornament also, and after the ornament destroys also, it will be there, isn't it? So what is that which was there before, which is there now, in this body, expressing through this body, or made out of which this body is made up, and it will continue to be after this body, breath, mind, intellect is destroyed. What is that? That is worthy of contemplation while living. Otherwise, punarapi jananam, punarapi maranam. That is worthy of contemplation. Caught up in this reality, in the contemplation of this reality. And as we have said before, nothing special needs to be done. Keep doing whatever has to be done. But don't forget that it's all a game. So don't be too serious about it. Keep your attention on the conscious principle.
Consciousness, which is a reflection of the pure consciousness.
Yes.
Is the consciousness, is it also not
real?
It is not real.
No. Waker is appearing only because of the waking world. Mm-hmm. Dreamer is appearing because of dream world. Mm-hmm. Deep sleeper is appearing because of dream world. If the waking world goes away, where does the waker go? He also dies, isn't it? Mm-hmm. Is the waker always 24 hours a day? No. Once you go to sleep, dreamer will begin. Where has the waker gone? So if the waker is coming and going, he is not real. Understand? Just like you are right now, because you are in front of me, you consider yourself to be a student. Next moment your wife comes, you will become a husband. So husband is appearing only because of the wife. The student is appearing only because of the teacher. The driver is appearing only when the car when he sits inside the car. So they are mutually supportive of each other. Exactly the same way, consciousness, the I thought, is only existing because of the that thought. Understand? It is that one pure reality, pure consciousness, which expresses as the I thought and the that thought, consciousness and matter, sentiency and insentiency. But both are in, where does it appear, the I thought and the that thought? In the mind. It's a projection, it's a phenomena. So when we are looking at consciousness, we can't look at, but the supreme I and the I which is associating with that thoughts, the nature is same, isn't it? The waker, dreamer, deep sleeper, all is I only. They cannot be anything else. There's, it's not that some other I has come inside. So put attention on this I, and slowly, slowly, from Karunatma to Mithyatma to Mukhyatma, it will happen. But attention has to be on the I, attention has to be on the conscious principle, attention has to be on the conscious principle. Indifference to names and forms results in being more and more firmly established in contemplation. Upekshite laukike dhihi, upekshite laukike dhihi, nirvigna brahma chintane, nirvigna brahma chintane, natavat krutrimasthayam, natavat krutrimasthayam, nirvahatyeva laukikam, nirvahatyeva laukikam. When the notion of reality in worldly objects is rejected, the intellect contemplates on the nature of Brahman without any obstacles. Such a wise man, like an actor, carries on his worldly dealings, giving them an artificial reality. Upekshite laukike dhihi. Dhihi means intellect. When the intellect becomes indifferent to the worldly transactions, laukike, in the world, when the intellect becomes indifferent in the world to the various transactions, to whatever is coming to it, then nirvigna brahma chintane, then alone nirvigna. Nirvigna means without any obstacles. What are the obstacles? Thoughts of the world. Thoughts of the world are the obstacles. Nirvigne, no thoughts of the obstacles, and such a person, that intellect, without any obstacles, is able to contemplate on Brahma Chintane. Chintana, contemplation on what? Brahma. So to the extent we have become indifferent to the worldly transactions, to that extent our intellect can contemplate on the I, the consciousness, the conscious principle. It will be automatic, you don't have to worry about it. It will automatically happen. But the prerequisite is indifference. Does indifference mean not performing in the world? No. Indifference means not giving value to anything in the world. Doing whatever is required to be done, but not giving value to it in the world. Just like you don't give value to the reflection in the mirror, you don't give value to the sunrise and sunset, you don't give value to the mirage waters, like that. You don't give value to the world, your total attention is automatically gets directed towards the Brahma, the reality. Such a wise man, like an actor, carries on his worldly dealings, giving them an artificial reality. What happens to us? you will experience this. Sometimes now you understood that outside interactions have to be like an actor. You start doing the acting and you become serious about it. And you forget that you are the reality. See? When total indifference to the world of names and forms is developed, one is able to focus attention on the essence, that is the Brahma Tattva, without any obstacle. How does such a Jivan Mukta Purush conduct himself in the world? Here it is told. He is like an actor on the stage. This is 1625, page 1625, last paragraph. He is like an actor on the stage, acting his part so brilliantly that the audience believes that the part he plays is true, but he himself knows he is other than the person whose role is being played on the stage. His acting is only an illusion. He does not take the role he is playing even a little seriously in real life. When can you play the role to its maximum? In a disidentified identification. In a disidentified identification, only then. Because if you are totally identified, then you might go through emotional turmoil while you are acting. And you will not, you will lose the plot. You will become too serious. You are supposed to, on the stage, you are supposed to murder someone and kill someone, and you are taking it so real that you don't want to kill that person. You are supposed to fall in love and then drop that person. You fall in love and forget. Now you got attached. Now how will the story continue? Only in a disidentified identity. You have to be indifferent to the whole thing, yet doing the role 100%. Only when you are disconnected with the whole thing, knowing that you are someone else, but this is the position, this is the place where you have been kept at this moment, you will do 100, automatically 100% will come out in that moment. He is just living in this world, acting his role in great fun and joy. Great masters may be suffering from grave illness, but they are always in joy because they know that health and disease are in them and not the other way. What is the other way? That, like, we feel that why has the disease come to me, why I don't want this disease. They don't say that I don't want. Their interaction is the health and disease are in me. Their attention is on the conscious principle. A dead body does not get any disease. It perishes. In such a Jivan Mukta Purusha, is such a Jivan Mukta Purusha subjected to modification? Pravahatyapi niredhaha, pravahatyapi niredhaha, sthira praudhashila yatha, sthira praudhashila yatha, nama rupan yatha tvepi. नामरूपा यथा त्वेपि कूटस्थं ब्रह्मनान्यथा कूटस्थं ब्रह्मनान्यथा. Just as large rocks lying on the river bed are firm and stable, although the water above them is constantly flowing, so also in spite of the constantly changing names and forms, Brahman, like an anvil, never undergoes any modifications. You are that. You are that reality. In spite of all the onslaught of names and forms, you are not. Imagine you are the riverbed. The water in the river is constantly moving. It is supported by the riverbed and strong stones. But the support does not move when the supported moves. In the same way, although the Jivan Mukta Purusha may be functioning very dynamically in the world, or he may be totally inert, He does not undergo any change, nor does he support any change. The names and forms may keep changing, but this I is other than the changing names and forms. How can this I, this Brahman, be subject to any modifications? It is not possible. It is the foundation itself. It is the substratum. And what is that substratum? It is self-knowing, all-knowing, ever-existing, eternal, all-pervasive. It is the material and the efficient cause of everything. So how can it be disturbed? How can it go through any modifications? Have you gone through any modifications? Have you gone through any modifications? No. Mind goes through all the modifications, intellect goes through all the modifications, breath goes through all the modifications, body goes through all the modifications. Past, present, future are in the mind. All duality is in the mind. The waker with the waking world, dreamer with the dream world, deep sleeper with no world, they are also, all these are in the mind. They are just projections in the mind. Do you know that all these come and go? Yes. Find out who that real one is. For that, at this moment, you have to discard the waker also. At this very moment, you have to discard the waker, along with the dreamer and the deep sleeper. Then alone, the moment you take that position, yes, I know that I was the waker, dreamer and deep sleeper yesterday. For that one split second, you have been the real you, the witness. But we lose the plot. Again, we become the waker. So this Brahman, this reality, does not undergo any modifications. All modifications are in the mind. All modifications are in the prakriti. Not in the reality. How in the pure self there is no trace of dualism or duality? Nishchidre darpane bhati, nishchidre darpane bhati, vastu garbham bruhadviyat, vastu garbham bruhadviyat, sachid ghane tatha nana, सच्चित घने तथा नाना जगत गर्भमिदं वियत जगत गर्भमिदं वियत. Just as the vast space along with its contents exists in a flawless mirror as a reflection, so also the space along with its contents called the world exists in the conscious existence in one partless Brahman. This is very important verse to contemplate. Very important verse. Just like when we see the space reflected in the mirror, we see the whole world. We see the movement, we see the breeze, we see the movement of the trees, we see the people crying, we feel see the emotions. Isn't it? Whether you take a mirror or you take the TV screen, it gives you a reality. Nowadays with the virtual glasses, you can feel as if you are in that whole dream experience, isn't it? Imaginary experience. But is that experience in a virtual movie, is that experience real? It's only an imagination. Similarly, here also, just as the space appears to be real with all its contents in the reflection, exactly the same way the whole world exists in the mind. Just as the reflection of the space appears in the mirror, similarly the world space, the world, where is it existing? In the space. Where is the space? In the mind. In the mirror which has no hole or emptiness, the whole space with all its contents seems as if they are inside the mirror, but they are not. In the same way, in the pure consciousness, that is in the pure self, in which there is no trace of dvandva or dvaita, the whole space bhutakasha with its contents appears as if it has entered Brahman. It means that the whole world of names and forms disappears. Nichidre darpane bhati vastu garbham bruhat vyat sachit ghane tatha nana jagat garbham idam vyat. Just as in the mirror, the whole world, the space appears with all its inclusions. Similarly, the whole world appears and disappears. Appears out of Brahman as if, and disappears back into Brahman, but without creating any modification in the Brahman, because it is the substratum. How the substratum is included in the perceptions of names and forms is stated in the next shloka. This part we have done before, many times it has come in our thoughts. Adrishtva darpanam naiva, adrishtva darpanam naiva, tadantasthekshanam tatha, tadantasthekshanam tatha, amatva sachidanandam, amatva sachidanandam, namarupamatikutaha. Without having seen the mirror, there can never be a vision of the contents reflected therein. So also, without having accepted the substratum, which is the blissful conscious existence, how can there be the knowledge of names and forms? Understand now, this is very, very subtle thing. The surface of the mirror itself is becoming the entire reflected space and all the objects, correct? Without the mirror, could you have a reflection? Not possible. Exactly the same way. Without the substratum, can you have the projection? Not possible. Without the, your mirror is taken as the unchanging, unchanging principle on which all the changes, that is the reflection of the space, the birds flying, the wind moving, etc., etc., is seen. But actually speaking, mirror has not undergone any change, even though changes are seen on the mirror, isn't it? Exactly the same way. On the waters of the ocean, changes are seen, but from ocean's point of view, there are no changes. On the gold, we see the changes, but from the gold's point of view, there are no changes. Similarly, on this substratum, this Brahman, this reality that we are, all the changes as if appear, but actually there are no changes. The reality is the I. On this I, imagine now this mirror is made up of I. And we are that mirror. And on this screen of the mirror, of I, the annamaya kosha, pranamaya kosha, manomaya kosha, space, air, fire, water, earth, all the things that you can think, all this is appearing on this mirror of consciousness. Can you come to know the whole world of change without being yourself? Without the I, can you come to know the whole world? You cannot come to know, isn't it? But you are thinking that I am experiencing the world. I is separate to the world. This is also a phenomena. But once you come to realize that I am, is the I thought is the one which is interacting, but the real I behind the I thought is the substratum, the witness. That is, to get to that stage, various sadhanas are given. Be equanimous, be balanced in mind, be indifferent to the world, contemplate on the self. All these are different ways. Tada drashtu swarupe avasthanam. All these are ways to come back to be the substratum. Be the substratum. And once you come there, then you will see this interaction of that whole thing is just a drama. Okay. Whole thing is just a game. It's just a drama. Brahma arpanam brahma vi. Self playing with self. Oh, waves are nothing but water playing with water. Isn't it? Water playing with water is wave. Self playing with self is leela, the game, the drama. When objects are reflected in the mirror, this itself shows that there is a mirror. Although Brahman is the very substratum of names and forms, the latter are seen but not the Brahman. Just like when we are watching the mirror, we see the reflection but we do not see the mirror. When we are watching the movie on the TV, we see the movie but we do not see the screen. Similarly, when we are watching this whole world, gross, subtle and causal, we do not see the substratum, we see what is coming and going. Understand? So come back. Recognize, just like in that, for the TV movie to appear, there must be a screen. For this whole phenomena of waking dream and deep sleep, there must be a screen. And that screen is I. That substratum is I. Nothing is perceived in the world unless it has these three qualities, asti, bhati and priya. Asti means it is, bhati means it appears, and priya means it is important, dear or useful. These three qualities are the reality aspect of the manifestation. Names and forms are the illusory aspect of expression of the world. In the perception of the names and forms, the substratum with its three qualities of the asti, bhati, priya is included. But we do not see the substratum because of our wrong priorities. We have seen this before. Every experience that we have, it is, I know it is dear or useful or important for me, and whatever is important for me must have a name and form. That is how we interact with the world. The asti, bhati, priya is the aspect of the reality, and naam and roop, name and form, is the aspect of the illusion. And what are we giving more important to? We are giving important to name and form. We are not giving important to the isness, that I know it is, that it is dear to me. That asti, bhati, priya we are not giving. We are not finding out from where that aspect is coming from. We are only lost in nama and roop. Therefore, the type of abhyasa practice needed to correct this incomplete vision is indicated. Prathamam Satchidanande, Prathamam Satchidanande, Bhasamane Tatavata, Bhasamane Tatavata, Buddhim Niyamyanai Vordhyam, Buddhim Niyamyanai Vordhvam, Dharaye Namarupayoho, Dharaye Namarupayoho. Having fully comprehended the blissful conscious existence, thereafter the intellect should be fixed in that Brahman alone, and the names and forms should never be entertained in the intellect. By repeated abhyasa, one is able to be one with one's own real self. This is not done by struggling to reject the names and forms, but by being indifferent to them. Upekshe nama rupe dve. To that extent, the mind will be calm. Then one is able to observe the mind without thought. Otherwise, what happens? Mind without thought, we go to sleep. But when we have consciously practiced indifference without going, without getting bored, without getting lethargic, without losing the plot, then when the mind becomes empty, we are still awake to it. We are still awake to it. Which mind? Which has got nothing as content within it. In this absence, I is present, then who knows that there is nothing, no content in the mind? I, be that. Don't focus, don't get lost in the nothingness. When the knowledge is in the form of it is present, it is intellectual understanding. When it is in the form of I am present, it is aparoksha anubhuti. This I is the first person. It is being in touch with one's own essential nature. So when mind is empty and you are there and the feeling is it is there, it is present, still it is objective in nature. But when I am present, it is subjective. You are abiding in your own essential self. Then all the perceptions and experiences are under one's total control. Thereafter, the names and forms are accepted only as illusion, not as reality. Just as dreams are considered to be illusion after one wakes up, when one is able to transcend simultaneously the waker, the waking world, and the waking experience, thereafter the world will continue but will not touch us. So this is how, what I just told you before, waker with the waking world, dreamer with the dream world, deep sleeper with the deep sleep world, all have to be considered as appearing on the mirror of the consciousness. They come and go. Abhi mat chalana ha? They come and go. Just like the various pictures on the movie screen come and go. So one must not be obsessed with name and form. And the nature of this experience is evam cha nirjagat brahma, evam cha nirjagat brahma, sachidananda lakshanam, sachidananda lakshanam, advaitananda etasmin, advaitananda etasmin, vishramyantu janashchiram, vishramyantu janashchiram. In this manner, one discovers Brahman to be free of the world of duality, and it is conscious, blissful existence. May the seeker of the truth rest ever in this non-dual bliss. Now, this is the blessing of the teacher on the seeker, on the student who has studied this Panchadashi, that having explained the nature of the or the disposition of the realized master, that he takes the world to be a drama, he takes the world to be a game, he takes the world to be an illusion, never losing that the reality is the I, reality is the self, on whom this whole experience, the transitory experience, is coming and going. In this the pure self where there is no plurality, no dvaita, this is the nature of the Satchidananda Brahman. And that you are. That you are. You are the substratum. In this non-dual, absolute, causeless, beyond logic, blissful, conscious existence, the teacher says, giving a blessing, may we rest forever. Meaning, may we abide in it forever. Whether he says or doesn't say, we are always abiding in it. But what is the teacher doing? Reminding us of our true nature. Just like when a small child is growing up, that small child speaks about himself or herself in a third person. Now, Saket will wants to wear shoes. Now Saket wants his school bag. Now Saket will go to school. Now Saket wants to go in a car. And how do we train the child? Don't say in that third person. Speak in first person. I want to go to school. I am hungry. I want to wear the shoes. I want to carry the bag. So just like we have trained that naturally, the child knows that all this is not him. But he's not established in the self. But it is natural. He sees everything as separate to him. Then 20, 30, 40, depending upon your luck, potluck, how long you are identified, then again the backward journey, reverse journey begins. That you have to speak everything in third person. See? So whether we are child, whether we are youth, whether we are old age, whether we are dead, as this body is dead, we never cease to be the reality that we are. We never cease to be the reality. Before birth, we were the reality. During this experience of life, from birth to death, we are the reality. After death also, we are the reality. Those people who consider themselves to be the soul, in the Dvaita Vad, the soul was before, therefore he could enter the body, isn't it? Otherwise, from where will the soul come? So soul must be existing before in order to enter a womb. Then the child is born. Then that soul is expressing through this body throughout the life. Then death comes. So soul was before, soul is now while living life. And when the death of the body comes, soul leaves the body and continues to be. So has anyone died? Has anyone died? Nobody has died. Because soul is the continuous principle. Soul can never die. It was before, it is now, and it will continue to be. Then what was not before, what is now, and what will not be afterwards? The body, breath, mind, intellect. That's right. So this equipment was not there before. Then at the birth, the equipment called body, breath, mind, intellect comes about. And then at death, this equipment called body, breath, mind, intellect perishes. But we feel that we have perished. And we feel that, oh, what will happen? This person has died unnecessarily. That fellow will find another body. Don't worry. Phenomena will continue. But we become so serious. My God, I cannot live without. Because we have given more importance to the name and form and not the conscious principle that is expressing through that equipment. This is what the difference is between a Mahatma and a common man. Common man or an ignorant person lives at the level of names and forms. The Mahatma lives at the level of consciousness, at the level of divinity. He knows. They chant, all these people, Na jayate mriyate neva kadachit. Nainam chindanti shastrani, nainam dahati pavakaha. The soul cannot be cut, the soul cannot burn. Then why are you afraid of death? Then why do you cry at someone else's death? See? So this is all lip service that we do to this information without making it subjective. Little bit time is to be spent. Contemplate on who you are. Come to the right conclusion that I am the indestructible principle. I am the one because of whom the whole world is existing. In fact, the whole world is existing only in me. And it's only an appearance. Nothing is real in this world. The waker with the waking world, dreamer with the dream world, deep sleeper with the deep sleep world. This is our total experience of life every day. And all three come and go. Whatever comes and goes cannot be real. The one who supports that which comes and goes is the real. So body is coming and going, it is not real. Soul, which is permanent, it was before, it is now, it is afterward. That is the real principle. Exactly the same way. That soul, another word for it, I, another word for it, Paramatma. The conscious principle. It is the permanent principle. Now concluding the chapter, Brahmananda Bidhe Granthe, Tritiyodhyaya Iritah, Advaitananda Eva Syat, Jagan Mithyatva Chintaya. In the third chapter of this third section of the book named Brahmananda, the non-dual bliss is declared. This can be attained by contemplation on the knowledge that the world is an illusion. So this is the third chapter in the Anand. So remember, first five chapters were Sat, based on Sat, expression of Sat, existence. Second five chapters, chapters 6 to 10, were on Chit. And these last five chapters are on Ananda. So first one we saw was the Brahmanande Yoganandaha. Second one we saw was Brahmanande Atmanandaha. And this third chapter we are seeing Brahmanande Advaitanandaha. And that Advaitananda, that one where no duality exists, Brahmananda, that supreme reality is that where Advaita, which is one without a second, there is no question or duality or dualism. And therefore, wherever there is no duality or dualism, there alone Ananda naturally expresses. If you want to think and laugh, you can never laugh. You have to stop thinking. If you try to understand a joke and laugh, you will never understand. But the moment joke is understood, that very moment everything stops, thinking stops. Think about whenever you are laughing, think, or just after you come out of the laughter, think that whether you were thinking at that time or not. Laughter comes when there are no thoughts in the mind. Because one cannot think and laugh. So all this thinking that this chapter has prompted us to contemplate upon is to come to non-thinking. Non-thinking is in the mind. Mind is a phenomena. And who are we? The one who is the substratum of that phenomena. And where is this thinking? The first, as I am repeating again, I have said it a few times, our total experience of the day is the phenomena called waker and waking world, dreamer with dream world, and deep sleeper with no world. This is our total one day experience. And what are we obsessed about? Only the waking world. Aray, your whole day is about these three. You have to take the three. And if you are giving reality to the waking world so much, then you must give equal reality to the dream world also and the deep sleep world also. But what is our disposition? We have taken deep sleep to be granted, taken for granted, and the dream world, the moment we wake up, we give it zero value. We never stretch it the next day. We never go back to the same dream to experience, continue from where we left last night. Then why this insistence to do that with respect to the waking world? This is where the man is going wrong. And that is only if your attention is on God realization. some people, here we are thinking, same thing is brought about by doing japa sadhana, same thing is brought about by doing kundalini sadhana, kriya yoga. When in Patanjali yoga it is told, atha yoga anushasanam chitta vritti nirodha iti yogaha. Chitta vritti nirodha, dissolution of all the thoughts in the mind is yoga. And when that happens, then what to do? Third step, tada drashtuhu swarupe avasthanam, come to be established in the swarup, the I, the undivisible principle that you are. See, as long as our insistence is on the names and forms of the world, till then we will be buffeted left, right, center. Will be thrown this side, that side. There'll be joys and sorrows. There'll be, ambitions. There'll be anxieties. There'll be guilts. There'll be so unlimited challenges. But in spite of that, if the spark has lit in the seeker's mind that I am the substratum, scriptures are saying it again and again. Let me give it a go once at least. Come to recognize that yesterday also you were, today also you are, tomorrow also you will be. But the waker was yesterday, then he was replaced by dreamer, then he was replaced by deep sleeper. Again this morning the waker came, now after some time the dreamer will come or the sleeper will come. All these are going. But have you ever... you have experienced the coming and going of waker, dreamer and deep sleeper with their respective worlds, but have you experienced your absence? Have you experienced the absence that I am not? I have experienced the absence of the waker. I have experienced the absence of the dreamer. I have experienced the absence of the deep sleeper. But have I experienced my own absence? It has not happened yet, isn't it? It can never happen. So get the plot right, then there is fun. See the plot that we have created and got caught up. And this plot you didn't create, it's a phenomenon, it's happening. Not just to you, to everyone. Krishna did not get caught up in the plot. He was the master of the plot. Yet, not influencing anything, doing what was required to be done. So in your life also, you do what is required to be done, but without attachment, with indifference, with attention on the God within our heart or the consciousness that we are. Move through life in this. You think Mirabai did not feel hungry? You think Mirabai did not change clothes? You think all the great Satya Sai Baba, Shirdi Sai Baba, did they not go through the various things? They all went through various experiences, but they did not allow the experiences to affect their disposition. They did not feel that these experiences are from the outside. They are the source. Within them, these experiences are taking place. Right now, we feel in the world we have come, and this world will continue and will go one day. But the truth is exactly the opposite. I have been always permanent. In me, the world comes, and in me, the world goes. Every morning, the waking world comes. Then in the evening, the waking world goes. I continue. The dream world comes. The dream world goes. I continue. The non-manifestation of the world called deep sleep, that happens, and that also goes after some time. So this phenomena of waking, dream and deep sleep comes and goes. That is my total experience. But I do not come and go. Again and again reiterating this and coming to be established that I am the unchanging principle. I am the substratum. And the whole world is in me rather than me in the world. This shift in vision has to come about. Shift in perception has to come about. And this is the intent of this chapter, that I am of the nature of Advaitananda. All the duality and dualism does not exist in me. I am the non-dual principle. The duality and dualism is only in the phenomena. I support the phenomena. No doubt, I support the phenomena, but I am not the phenomena. I am much more than the phenomena. Just like the waters support the phenomena of the waves, but the waters are much more than the waves. In fact, waters are nothing but the wave. We are giving the name to the water called waves. But when you touch a wave, taste a wave, feel a wave, you are touching water. Similarly, the entire phenomena is nothing but Satchidananda Swarup. But our insistence on name and form stops us from realizing that it is the expression of the reality. So this whole world is nothing but the reality, but we must have the eye for that. Advaitanandam is the reality, and the world of names and forms is illusory. This Advaitananda can be discovered by contemplating constantly on one theme, that is, the world is mithya and does not merit being given importance and value. We have gone much more beyond that in that understanding. World is mithya, meaning what? That the names and forms are mithya. The changing aspect of the world is mithya. Because what is that? Mithya means the illusion. World is the illusion. But what is it made up of? Asti, bhati, priya, nama, roop. This nama, roop is the mithya. Asti, bhati, priya is the reality. Without this I, this experience of the world is not possible. So bring attention, let every experience, every contact, every whatever you see, hear, touch, feel, taste, everything remind you of that I. Don't get lost. Hari Om Tat Sat. Om Purnamada Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnameva Vashishyate. Om Shanti Shanti Shanti. Hari Om Shri Gurubhyo Namaha. Hari Om. Just sit quietly for a minute.